In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace and peace to you from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
Good morning, brothers and sisters, and welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. The fourth Sunday of Easter, which is today, is Good Shepherd Sunday. This image of Christ speaks of his love, care, and self-giving unto death. It also reminds us of his victory through which we are delivered from a futile way of life. This Sunday also is World Day of Prayer for Vocations. We implore the Lord to send shepherds of souls who can lead us to him and who, like him, can give themselves for the good of the flock. Let us pray for more vocations bound to serve God through the church. And so, brothers and sisters, let us all make ourselves worthy to celebrate the sacred mysteries as we call to mind all our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Altogether, I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask, Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. After curing a cripple, Peter and John proclaim before the leaders of Israel that their power comes from Jesus, who was crucified but was raised from the dead.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter, filled with the Holy Spirit, said, "Leaders of the people and elders, if we are being examined today about a good deed done to a cripple, namely, by what means he was saved, then all of you and all the people of Israel should know that it was in the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, whom you crucified, whom God raised from the dead. In his name, this man stands before you healed. He is the stone rejected by you, the builders, which has become the cornerstone. There is no salvation through anyone else, nor is there any other name under heaven given to the human race by which we are to be saved." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The stone rejected by the builders has become a cornerstone. The stone rejected by the builders has become a cornerstone.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in man. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes.
The stone rejected by the builders has become a cornerstone.
I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done. It is wonderful in our eyes.
The stone rejected by the builders has become a cornerstone.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. We bless you from the house of the Lord. I will give thanks to you, for you have answered me and have been my Savior. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his kindness endures forever.
The stone rejected by the builders has become a cornerstone.
John invites us to marvel at the grace of God, who now calls us his children in his Son Jesus, who offered his life for all of us.
A reading from the first letter of Saint John. Beloved, see what love the Father has bestowed in us, that we may be called the children of God. Yet so we are. The reason the world does not know us is that it did not know him. Beloved, we are God's children now. What we shall be has not yet been revealed. We do know that when it is revealed, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Please stand.
Hallelujah.
the good shepherd, says the Lord, I know my sheep, and mine know me.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. A good shepherd lays down his life for the sheep. A hired man who is not a shepherd and whose sheep are not his own sees a wolf coming and leaves the sheep and runs away. And the wolf catches and scatters them. This is because he works for pay and has no concern for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know mine, and mine know me. Just as the Father knows me, and I know the Father, and I will lay down my life for the sheep. I have other sheep and that do not belong to this fold. These also I must lead. And they will hear my voice, and there will be one flock and one shepherd. This is why the Father loves me, because I lay down my life in order to take it up again. No one takes it up from me, but I lay it down on my own. I have power to lay it down and power to take it up again. This command I have received from my Father. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Minsan o marahil, madalas o maraming beses sa buhay natin ay natanong na natin ang tanong na ito, nasaan ba ang Panginoon? Ito ay pumapasok sa ating isipan o kaya lumalabas sa ating mga bibig kapag ka tayo ay nasa gitna o nasa pagkakataon na tayo ay nawawala. Nawawala tayo sapagkat hindi na natin alam kung tutuloy pa ba tayo sa ating direksyon na tinahak o babalik pa ba tayo o hindi na natin alam ang daan pabalik o kung mayroon pa ba tayong babalikan. We are just lost in the middle of nowhere. We are lost because we did it our way. Tayo ay nawawala sapagkat sinunod natin ang ating kagustuhan. Sapagkat marahil ay maraming nag-udyok sa atin upang tahakin ang daan na ito. Marahil ay gusto ko lang sapagkat para sa akin ito ang nararapat at para sa akin ito ang tama. Para sa akin ito ang daan o ang direksyon na aking tatahakin. And then in the middle of nowhere, when we do not know anymore where to go and what to do, we look for someone. We ask for someone. Nasaan ka, Panginoon? Bakit ako nawawala? Marahil tayo nawawala sapagkat nakalimutan natin na sundan ang boses o ang gabay ng totoong nangangalaga sa atin, ang totoong nagsusubaybay at nagbibigay sa atin ng tuwid na daan. Tinatanong natin, bakit wala ka? Nasaan ka, Panginoon? Bakit ako nawawala? Bakit hindi ko alam ang aking patutunguhan? Marahil sapagkat ay nawala na o nakalimutan natin, no, ang hugis, ang mukha, ang boses ng ating mabuting pastol. And so we ask to be brought back to the fold. Minsan naman nagtatanong tayo, nasaan ba ang Panginoon kapag tayo walang-wala? Walang-wala sapagkat maraming nangyari sa buhay natin. Marahil nasira ang ating negosyo, nawalan tayo ng trabaho, laganap ang gutom, marami ang walang-wala sa mundong ito. Nagkaroon ng crisis ng buong mundo, nasa gitna tayo ng pandemya, parang maging ang ating pag-asa ay nauubos na rin. Maging ang ating pananampalataya, ang ating tiwala sa ating mga sarili ay unti-unti na rin nauubos. And then we ask, andyan ka ba? Nasaan ka? Are you with us? in this moment of crisis, in this moment of struggles that we have, in this moment of tragedy. O kaya minsan naman, tinatanong natin, nasaan ba ang Panginoon? Nasaan ka? Kapag ka tayo'y nagwawala dahil sa galit, sapagkat punong-puno ng puot ang ating mga puso, nagagalit tayo sapagkat parang napupuno na ng kamalasan ang buhay natin, nagagalit tayo sapagkat parang lahat na lang ng kapahamakan ay nasa akin. Bakit hindi ko natupad ang aking mga pangarap? Bakit hindi naging tama ang buhay ko sa kabila ng aking pagsisikap na gawing tama ang lahat? Bakit mali ang kinahinatnan ng aking buhay? And we are angry. We are full of hatred. And we ask, where are you? Tinatanong natin kung nasaan ang Diyos. Hindi dahil marahil kailangan natin ng tulong. Hindi marahil kailangan natin ng kalinga. Hinahanap natin siya kapag tayo'y nagwawala sapagkat gusto natin mayroong masisi sa mga pangyayari sa buhay natin. Kaya tinatanong natin, bakit? Bakit mo kinuha ang mahal ko sa buhay? Bakit mo kinuha ang aking anak? Bakit kinuha mo ang aking kapatid? Bakit kinuha mo ang taong malapit sa akin? Mabuti na lang at alam natin na siya ang kumuha sa mga mahal natin sa buhay. Sapagkat lahat naman tayo, siya ang nagmamay-ari. Tama lang na tayo bumalik sa kanya. Ang nakakatakot, no? Kapag ka hindi siya ang kumuha sa atin. At kung iba ang may kumuha sa atin. Subalit sa kabila ng lahat ng ito, sa panahon na tayo nawawala, nagwawala at walang wala, hinahanap natin ang Panginoon. At kapag humupa na ang lahat ng ito, kapag ka na maayos na ulit ang buhay natin, we have moved on, naunawaan na natin ang mga pangyayari sa buhay natin, sinasagot din naman natin ang ating mga sarili. Hindi naman talaga tayo pinabayaan ng Panginoon. Hindi naman talaga nawawala ang Panginoon. Hindi tumalikod ang Panginoon sa atin. Sapagkat alam natin, nariyan lang siya. Andito lang tayo. Andito pa tayo. At alam natin, hindi tayo pinabayaan ng Panginoon. Sapagkat hindi naman yon ang totoong tanong, nasaan ang Diyos? Sapagkat alam natin ang sagot sa tanong na ito. Ang totoong tanong sa buhay natin ay hindi kung nasaan ang Diyos. Ang totoong tanong sa mundong ito at sa buhay natin ay ang tanong ng Diyos para sa atin. Nasaan ka? Where are you? And it is the real question of Jesus. Jesus is a good shepherd tending his flock. He is a good shepherd who loves every member or every sheep of the flock. Kaya nga, siya ay sinalarawan na isang mabuting pastol sapagkat kapag ka meron siyang isang daang tupa at ang isa ay nawawala, pwede niyang iwanan, no, ang siyam na putsyam upang hanapin ang isang nawawala. Sapagkat lagi siyang nagtatanong, nasaan ka? Bakit ka nawawala? And I will be looking for you. And the moment the Lord finds you, the lost sheep, He will rejoice. And time and again, Jesus would tell us, great is the rejoicing in heaven by the angels when one man returns back to the fold. And then the good shepherd would call his neighbor and tell them, please, rejoice with me. Let us celebrate. I have found the lost sheep. Nasaan ka? Actually, this is the first question of God to man. Ito ang unang tanong ng Panginoon, ng Diyos, sa tao. Kailan? Nung ang tao ay tumalikod sa Diyos. Nung itinatwa o binaliwala o hindi sinunod ng ating unang mga magulang ang utos ng Diyos. When our first parents disobeyed God, the first question of God was not, why did you disobey me? No, it was not that question. But the question of God was, where are you? Nasaan kayo? And then they answered, we are hiding. We are hiding because we are naked. Nagtago. Hindi naman ang Diyos ang nagtatago sa atin. Tayo ang nagtatago sa Kanya. Nagtatago tayo sapagkat tayo'y natatakot, sapagkat tayo'y nahihiya, sapagkat alam natin na tayo ay sumuway at naging suwail sa Kanya. We are the ones being sought by God. Tayo ang hinahanap ng Diyos. At ang Diyos ay mabuting pastol at pinatunayan niya ito sa atin. Ang Diyos natin ay hindi ang Diyos na magpapabaya o ipapahamak tayo. He is not a punishing God. He is only a loving God. And He will keep His love forever for us. And it will never change. Hindi magbabago ang pagmamahal ng Diyos. Hindi magbabago ang Kanyang pangako. Kaya nga, pagkatapos magkasala ng ating mga magulang, unang magulang, pinangako niya ang tagapagligtas. And God fulfilled that promise. And in today's gospel, 5 times, no? Napakaiksi ng ating binasa sa Ebanghelyo. Subalit 5 beses, kung narinig kayo, inulit-ulit ng Panginoon, I will lay down my life for my sheep. Iahandog ko o iaalay ko ang aking buhay para sa aking mga tupa. And what a sacrifice for a good shepherd who loves his flock so much. And then the Lord will never stop looking when He said, I have other sheep that do not belong to this fold. And there will be, and these also I must lead. Hahanapin ko sila. Hindi ang Diyos ang nawawala. Sapagkat ang Diyos ay nariyan. He is everywhere. And if God is everywhere, we cannot go away from Him. We go north, He is there. We go south, He is there. East and west, He is there. We cannot escape the presence of God. But we can deny the presence of God. We can hide from God. Kapag ka tayo na mismo ay binulag natin ang ating mga sarili, sapagkat alam natin na nandyan lang siya, subalit tayo ang hindi kumikilala sa Kanyang presensya. Walang duda, sa pamamagitan ng Kanyang pagpapatunay ng Kanyang pagmamahal sa atin, sa pamamagitan ng Kanyang pagtupad ng pangako na tayo iligtas, ang Panginoon ay mabuting pastol. No doubt about that. But the other question is, what kind of sheep are we? Mabuti rin ba tayong tupa? At yun ang tanong na dapat nating sagutin. Hindi ang tanong na kung saan ang Diyos, kundi nasaan tayo? Nasa lugar pa ba tayo kung saan naroon ang Diyos? Anong klaseng mga tupa tayo? Are we as good as the shepherd that we follow? And the Lord is reminding us again, we take care of each other. We keep ourselves as one fold, listening to the one voice of the sheep. Mahal na mahal tayo ng Diyos. Siya ang Diyos ng pagpapatawad. Siya ang Diyos ng papagmahal. At ang Kanyang pagmamahal ay hindi magbabago sa atin kahit na tayo ay magbago sa Kanya. Kahit na hindi na natin siya mahalin, kahit talikuran natin siya, hindi siya makakalimot at hindi titigil at hindi magbabago ang Kanyang pagmamahal sa atin at hindi niya tayo iiwanan. Hindi katulad natin, no? Kapag ang mahal natin ay hindi na tayo mahal, ay hindi na rin natin sila mamahalin. Subalit ang Diyos ay hindi magbabago sa Kanyang pagmamahal. Mananatili ang Kanyang pagkalinga sa atin. Tayo ang Kanyang mga tupa na lagi niyang kakalingain, lagi niyang susubaybayan, lagi niyang patatawarin sa tuwing tayo nagkasala, lagi niyang hahanapin. Tayo ang mga tupa na laging mamahalin ng mabuting pastol. Let us all stand. Let us profess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Let us pray to the Father so that in following His Son Jesus, the Good Shepherd, we may become instruments of His love and care for His people. We implore Him and pray, Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer. Bless our Holy Father Pope Francis, our Bishop Socrates Villegas, priests, deacons, and all church ministers. Give them warm and caring hearts that they may be true shepherds of your people. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Grant that those in public office may be shepherds to those entrusted to their care, placing the welfare of others before their private interest and personal comfort. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Make our families and parishes fertile seedbeds of priestly, religious, and missionary vocations who will continue the mission of Good Shepherd, seeking out the lost and those outside the fold. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Inspire more young people to find meaning and happiness in a life that is offered to you and dedicated to the service of their brothers and sisters. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Embrace our departed loved ones into your loving arms, for being with you is your true home. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the urgent concerns of our community and our personal intentions. We pray.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer. We also pray for all the sick members of our families, especially those who are inflicted with the virus COVID-19, those who have died because of this virus. And we also pray for those people taking care of them, especially our medical workers and all other frontliners, for each member of our families, for the intentions of this Mass, and for those people we have promised to pray for, those who have no one to pray for them, and those who have asked for our prayers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, graciously hear our prayer.
God, our Father, your Son Jesus has shown us through his life and teachings how to serve and worship you. Through the intercession of Mary, Mother of the Good Shepherd, provide us with laborers who will make the church the sacrament of your presence. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated. please stand.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Santo, 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 Panginoon Diyos na makapangyarihan, dako puno ang langit at lupa ng panatilaan mo. O Sanda, sa kaitaasan, O Sanda, O Sanda,
You are indeed holy, O Lord, a fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Sa krus mo at magkabuhay, kapinag-ubos ng tunay, Panginoong Jesus, naming mahal, iligtas mo kami.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Socrates, our Bishop, Fidelis, his auxiliary bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her beloved spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Please stand.
Now, full of love and confidence, let us pray to God our Father in the words our Savior taught us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us give each other the sign of peace.
Peace be with you.
Thank you.
please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us everlasting life.
Amen. Please stand.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, thank you so much for joining us in the celebration of the Eucharist here at the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. May you have a meaningful pilgrimage and please have a safe trip back home. And also for our brothers and sisters joining us by a live stream, we also thank you for being with us and constantly celebrating with us the Eucharist here at the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag. We continue to pray for each other. And now please bow your heads and receive God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing.
Amen.
May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance.
Amen.
And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism, through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven.
Amen.
And may Almighty God bless you all, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass has been offered. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Now we shall have the prayer for the blessing and healing of our sick brothers and sisters. Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who made heaven and earth.
Let us pray. God, our Almighty Father, by your blessing, you give us strength and support in our frailty. Turn with kindness toward our sick brothers and sisters, free them from all sickness, and restore them to good health. Through the intercession of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now we shall have the blessing of your religious articles. Kung meron po kayong mga religious articles, pakilabas lang po. Bababa po kami dyan para basbasan ang inyong mga religious articles. Huwag na po kayong umalis sa inyong kinaroroonan para iwasan po natin ang pagdikit-dikit at manatilihin natin ang ating agwat o distansya. Let us pray. In memory of the mysteries of the life, death, and resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ, and to the honor and glory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of Christ and Mother of the Church, Our Lady of the Rosary of Manawag, may the rosaries, images, candles, oil, and other religious articles be blessed and made holy. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.